In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
Happy to be here with you. Thank you so much, and thank you to the folks here at Ascension for having us. This is a wonderful space to sing in, and your energy and everything that you bring to us is so needed, and you are very much a part of this with us. We hope that you are enjoying the beginnings of a holiday season of joys, large or small, gratitude, and of abundance. That mindset of abundance. We are here because we say that we're here, and you are here because you say that you're here, and so we are all sort of incarnated here together as a unique group of people today. It is a great, great, great honor and a privilege to be with you here. We are going to continue this program. I'm going to invite my wonderful associate conductor, Robbie Cowan, who's going to lead us in the Heli Willen Magnificat, and welcome, a warm welcome to you to this place. We're so glad that you're here.
For he hath regarded
With darkness.
ECMC is very proud to give the New York premiere of this piece. The premiere was done by a group in Washington, D.C. called the Capital City Hearings, which is a group that was planted years ago by a person who had sought after our work and the work of my other choir, Coral Chameleon, here in New York City as a model, and started this group in that model. This is a text by Yannick Morgan, a very poignant text, but we think it has a lot to do with incarnation. And I just want to read the text to you briefly, because as you know, if you've been with us for a long time, I tend to do that before pieces sometimes, just to make sure people are paying attention. Yes. And it's called Keep Close the Ghosts of Memphis. And here Yannick Morgan says, "When walking through my life up to a line drawn in the sand, I came upon a message written in my father's hand, the sign he carried weary through a daunting protest scene in Birmingham or Memphis Town or somewhere in between. I am a man," red words declared on tattered planks of wood, obvious and regal like the rites for which they stood. Yet underneath the seeping paint, an agony remained. The destruction of a man, his body, home, and treasures drained. So I'll take up that sign and cross the line drawn in the sand and march forward with my people arm in arm and hand in hand. For if I am the kind of man my father would have been, I'll keep close the ghosts of Memphis till my father's fight we win. We are what we say we are in the world. Are you with me? Yeah. Yeah. So, and the great composer Mike Rowan will be here with us Tuesday. He's coming up from D.C. But we are so delighted that you get to be the first to hear it in New York. I've waited for a long time to share this piece with all of you. This comes to us from the Argentinian composer, Ariel Ramirez, who brought us the Misa Criolla and various other things. For all my choral nerds in the room, this was an artifact. And I just have a quick anecdote about it, which is that my maternal grandmother knew nothing about concert music or, you know, symphonies or anything like that. And we were at one point cleaning out her house to downsize her and move her to a smaller apartment. And I found the LP of Misa Criolla, and I thought, what is my grandmother doing with this? I thought she only listened to Sinatra because she, you know, chased him up a hill and broke her ankle when she did that when he was in San Francisco. My family's crazy, okay, in more ways than one. But this composer is a true shining example to us of somebody who took the cultural artifacts of his upbringing, the joy that he felt experiencing the panoramic view of all that South America has to offer, and literally flipped the script, literally rewrote the history. And the way that I know that is because what you're about to hear is a work in six movements, very similar to a Baroque dance suite. And if you've heard a Baroque dance suite, you know, you have all these French, Allemande, Gigue, Courant, waltz, not waltz, but, you know, these different forms that are coming from the Western European tradition. And what Ramirez has done is he has taken that Baroquean form and replaced it with traditional dance forms and idioms from various places in South America. Therefore, rewriting in the form of this piece, subtly and tastefully, the dark and somber sting of colonialism, right? And so we love this piece. It seems to lend itself well to tenor bass voices. You can be the judge of that. You tell me after. We've worked really hard on the Spanish. I am particularly overjoyed to be joined by my very longtime colleague, Carlos Cuestas, on guitar, who many of you have heard play before, and boy, is this a rousing little thing. So you're not allowed to sit still in your seat when we do this, and I will have video evidence of it afterwards. Did you hear me? This is the beautiful Navidad Nuestra, the drama about the mystery of the incarnation from Ariel Ramirez. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. dos.
Thank you.
While the choir is coming back up, I just wanted to tell you one other thing that we're celebrating tonight and this weekend, and that is that some of you may know that this past Friday, the 8th of December, ECMC released its first commercially produced record album. With our friends at Navona Records, which is part of Parma Records. It's an international organization, and they have produced for some of the greatest choirs in the country, including The Crossing in Philadelphia and several of our other friends. The piece by Nicholas Weininger, which many of you came to hear last year in March, is a deep, deep comment on the nothingness that inflicted all of us so suddenly when the pandemic hit. And looking to the Hebrew scriptures in the beautiful poetic translations of Robert Alter to find solace and hope and figure out how to go on. It ends with the incredible Kaddish prayer, the Oseh Shalom, which is absolutely heart-wrenching. It is available now wherever you get your music. You can get it on Spotify, Apple Music, or one of the services that actually pays the artists, like Tidal, or, you know, it's a little better, so on and so forth. But we hope that you'll listen to it and that you'll share it with your family and your friends. It's all over social media. We, on the release day, had 2,000 listens of it immediately on Instagram, which we were really happy about. And I think this choir is very deserving of it, given the hard work that they've put in and that we are on this trajectory. Also, if you'll indulge me, this summer, ECMC will make its first ever appearance at GALA in Minneapolis, which is the International Association of Gay and Lesbian Choruses, and will perform on a stage in front of literally thousands of other LGBTQA plus identifying singers. In a special way, I will watch my former student, Jacob Stensberg, who had a secondary relationship with ECMC, who is now the artistic director of the San Francisco Gay Men's Chorus, perform there. Lots of really, really great things happening here. Also, I failed to say it at the beginning, but to those of you who are joining us live on Livestream, as you see, we're live streaming tonight, we welcome you to this space. Whoever you are and wherever you've come from, we are delighted, delighted that you're here with us, and we feel your presence just as much from wherever you are around the world. I know there's people watching from as far as Australia tonight. So this next song comes to us from Daniel Brubaker. And again, I'll just share the poem briefly. Speaking of incarnation, 'tis you that are the music, not your song. The song is but a door which, opening wide, lets forth the pent-up melody inside, your spirit's harmony, which clear and strong sings but of you. Throughout your whole life long, your songs, your thoughts, your doings, each divide this perfect beauty. Waves within a tide, or single notes amid a glorious throng. The song of earth has many different chords. Ocean has many moods and many tones, yet always ocean. In the damp spring woods, the painted trillium smiles, while crisp pine cones autumn alone can ripen. So is this one music with 1,000 cadences.
Your song.
future of the world.
Christmas song, Christmas carol, holiday New York artifact about a story from the Christian tradition about a woman who has all the power and the control, written by a Jewish boy from Brooklyn.
You just gotta love that.
You just gotta love that. And now, of course, we will do my contractually obligated repertoire for the year. Lest somebody's cousin in New Jersey come after me.
Oh.
Y'all doing okay out there? If you're okay, I'm okay. Now, I would encourage you, please, to take a look in your programs for the words, because you have a part in this next piece. And tonight, I'm holding auditions for ECMC. when I turn around and I conduct you, this will be very disorienting for the orchestra, so be nice and sing along fervently for their, you know, purposes, and that way they'll still buy me a drink after the concert. We haven't done this piece in several years, and it's kind of interesting that in this church, that this wonderful church that doesn't have an organ, we're trying it tonight with two pianos for the first time. And it's written, of course, by my teacher and friend, Conrad Sousa, who's always good for a real Christmas giggle. Let me tell ya. So before we end the concert with this wonderful medley, A Christmas Garland, let me thank you on behalf of all of us at Empire City Men's Chorus. Let me thank you for your openness, for your support, for being here, for being willing to open your hearts to us. I know some of the repertoire on this concert is not your conventional Christmas repertoire, but we hope that the message that you take away from this place in this theme of incarnations is that you have all of the power to become who you say you are in the world. And only you have that power. And we sing music tonight about that. This isn't just about some biblical story from years ago, tales of yore. This is about all of humanity at the most critical time, I'm sure you would agree. But you know, whoever you are and wherever you've come from, whatever you believe or don't believe, whatever you've brought in here with you tonight, know this, know that you are loved. And the evidence is in the way this choir sings to you. They've waited for you for so long, and you mean the world to us. Please do consider visiting us online at empirecitymenschorus.org or ecmc.nyc and figure out how you might get involved. Our door is open to you. ECMC this year celebrates 30 years doing this in New York City. We have amazing things happening in the spring. We're going to appear with the Queer Urban Orchestra, and we have a brand new commission coming from the composer Jeffrey Parola, and we need your support, and we need your love to make it happen. You've done so much already by being here with us tonight, but as you consider it at the end of the year, if you'd like to make a donation to ECMC, my goodness, it will go so far to help us, and we thank you so much for that as well. You are loved. Thank you for being here, and open your mouths and sing these Christmas songs, because Mama's working like a dog. Thank you for being here.
Oh.